Right, all right, yes, thank you very much for staying with us once again and joining us on this channel. Sports7GH. Don't forget the name. The name is Sports7GH. It's always a great pleasure to have you join us. Thank you very, very much for staying with us. Now, my name is Kingsley. Kingsley on Sports7GH. We are going to bring you the latest update surrounding the Ghanaian players, the Black Stars players. Tariq Lamptey, sad news hits. Tariq Lamptey, Brighton and Hove Albion defender, Ghana Black Stars defender. Yes, sad news hits him once again, and we are going to bring you the details of that particular sad news on this channel in this video. Also, we will look at Mohamed Kudus speaking about Barcelona. Yes, FC Barcelona. So we are going to give you the details of that story, and then also former Black Stars player saying that we cannot lose Andre Dede Ayew at this time. We shouldn't ask Dede Ayew out of the Black Stars at this time. We are going to discuss all of those issues with you. Very three hot issues we are going to discuss with you. I cannot do that alone. Please do all to leave your thoughts and comments below in the comment section of this video. Like the video, hit the notification bell, and select all. Leave your thoughts and comments below in the comment section if you have any. It's always a great pleasure to have you join us. Thank you very, very much for staying with us. Now, let's start from Tariq Lamptey. Sad news hits Tariq Lamptey, Brighton and Hove Albion defender, and then also Ghana Black Stars defender. You know that this season, Tariq Lamptey, he's been doing very well for Brighton, playing as a right back, playing as a left back, can even, he plays as a right winger also for Brighton and Hove Albion. So when it comes to one of those versatile players, Brighton and Hove Albion is having, then you are talking about Tariq Lamptey. He's one of them, and he's been doing very, very well for them. His last action for them was versus Arsenal when he caused a penalty for Arsenal. Okay, yes. Now the thing is that he has gotten injured again. Brighton and Hove Albion has revealed that Tariq Lamptey is injured again, and Roberto Di Zerbi revealed it today when he was doing his press conference for the weekend game Brighton and Hove Albion are going to play over there. So the unfortunate news is that Tariq Lamptey is injured again. It is not so much clear how many weeks or days or months he's going to be out for Brighton and Hove Albion, but it is a very, very sad news over there. All right, yes, don't forget that the Black Stars has a game to play in the month of June. So if he doesn't get back as soon as possible and doesn't start playing for Brighton and Hove Albion, maybe he will be out for that particular FIFA World Cup qualifier. Ghana Black Stars will be playing versus Mali in June. But let's talk to you about the injury records or the history of Tariq Lamptey's injury. Now, this season, he has already went out for about 41 days due to an injury. He went out for about 41 days. He missed 10 games this season. These are the official injury records of Tariq Lamptey. And if you look at Tariq Lamptey, his injury records are not good at all. In the 2022-2023 season, that is last season, he went out for a knee injury. 87 days he stayed out. Before the 87 days, he had already stayed out for a knee injury. 8 days also. Alright, the 87 days he went out, no, he missed both Brighton and Hove Albion games and then Ghana Black Stars games. Do you get a point? Good, he missed about 19 games over there. And then also in the 2020-2021 season, that is the season Tariq Lamptey was bombarded with a lot of injuries. In fact, that season, he just couldn't play a lot of games. Hamstring injury, rest. Okay, rest is just... But then hamstring injury again. Hamstring strain. And then hamstring injury. 13 days, 17 days, 70 days. And 196 days. He was missing about 27 games for both Brighton and Hove Albion and then Ghana Black Stars. So the history records or the injury records of Tariq Lamptey is so bad, and I don't know what is wrong with him, but he just cannot stop getting injured. And this time too, Roberto Di Zerbi has revealed that Tariq Lamptey is injured and will not be available for selection for the Brighton and Hove Albion game they'll be playing over the weekend. And it's a very, very sad news over there for a very fine player, versatile, resolute. He's so good wherever he's playing, whether left back, whether right back, whether right winger. He's delivering for his side, whether national team or the club side. So it's very unfortunate, but we wish him speedy recovery. That's what we can do, right? We wish him speedy recovery and we hope that he gets back way stronger. Mohamed Kudus is a fantastic Blasters player, Ghanaian player who plays for West Ham United. He's doing very, very well for West Ham United. In his first season for the club, he's involved in about 14 goals. In fact, he has scored 14 goals and then also a lot of assists over there. He's doing very, very well in all competitions. Now, Kudus was speaking to West Ham United media and he said that, look, he was asked which team did he watch the most growing up, and he said that Barcelona. And they asked that, what was it about? Like, why did you watch Barcelona? Why were you interested in Barcelona? He said that Messi, easiest one. Messi. You know, Kudus Mohamed, he's young. Yes, 22, 23 years. So he's like all of us. Is that not it? Good. So that age need here. What they were watching was Barcelona. You see, that time, you know, around 2006, 2008, that was when Barcelona was Barcelona. When Pep Guardiola had come in and was winning the Champions League, the league titles, beating Real Madrid 5-0 and the rest. So Kudus watched Barcelona and he says that he loves Barcelona. Doesn't mean that going forward he can actually, there's a chance that he will be going to Barcelona or what. I think that there is that move or there is that possibility, because Bernardo Silva has consistently told Man City that, look, he dreamt of playing for Barcelona, and irrespective of how Barcelona is currently, he wants to play for Barcelona. And so there is a news that next season he's likely to play for Barcelona or move to Barcelona. So if Kudus fell in love with Barcelona growing up, and you see how Barcelona right now, no, yeah, when gets no cry, you don't see quality. Yeah, Rafinha is not scoring like Kudus is scoring for West Ham. Yes, Yami Yama, cool. You get it? So they can come for Kudus and do something with Kudus. Yes, Mohamed Kudus at Barcelona, yeah, it will be fantastic. The Spanish La Liga is a cheap league. Everybody knows that it's a cheap league. The league, no, the competition in the league is very small, okay? It's not tough like that. So Kudus can go to Barcelona and spoil there for himself, for the club, and for all of us in Ghana to be very, very proud of him. But I think that it's going to take a lot of time for him to join Barcelona, if there is that possibility of him joining Barcelona. But my point is that if he has some soft spot for Barcelona, if he loved Barcelona growing up, then it means that he's likely to play for them at some point in his career. It's not right now, but at some point in his career, it's likely that he's going to play for FC Barcelona over there. Samuel Nkum is a fantastic Blasters player. Played for the Ghana under 20 team, helped Ghana to win the World Cup, under 20 World Cup 2009. Was a fantastic one. They were captained by Andrew Dede Ayew, and he came on to play the Blasters and the rest. Samuel Nkum is warning against kicking out Andrew Dede Ayew from the Blasters. Former Ghana defender Samuel Nkum believes that the Blasters need senior players like Andrew Dede Ayew to maintain a balance in the team. Ayew, the Blasters captain, has come under a lot of pressure following the team's recent struggles. Ghana failed to progress beyond the group stages of the last two African Cup of Nations and were eliminated from the first round at the 2022 FIFA World Cup. Despite the team's slump, Nkum insists Andrew Ayew is needed to play a motivating role for the youngsters in the squad. I believe if you have a team, you have to have the experienced ones and the young ones, because the young ones cannot just come like that. You are supposed to have experienced ones inside the team that can motivate them and can also encourage them, he told GH1 TV. Samuel Nkum continued to say, I don't think at the moment we have to kick Andre Ayew or maybe the senior players out of the team. They have to be in the team, give the young ones confidence, and say a lot of encouraging stuff, because I think that is how a team is supposed to be. Nkum and Ayew were part of the Ghana under 20 team that won the under 20 FIFA World Cup in 2009. You see that he didn't talk about his performance he would give on the pitch. He said that, oh, encouragement. Oh, Ghana, we are a funny country. If it is about encouragement, let's bring those senior players now. Let's add them to the backroom staff of the Blasters. We don't have to add them to the 23 players of the Blasters. That is my point. It's a simple one. I'll not talk too much. I'm not saying that they should by force leave, but I'm saying that if he's there as part of the Black Stars players, because of he's going to encourage the young ones and he's going to teach the young ones, blah blah blah, he's taking the space of somebody who needs time to groom up, who needs time to grow also. He's taking the space, so let him come to the managerial aspect, maybe backroom staff, maybe team manager, something like that. And then he will encourage the players. Everybody will look up to him and he will teach them and all of that. Why is he part of the Black Stars squad and he's taking up position of somebody who would have needed that time, okay, to grow or something? It's just as simple as that. Thank you very much for staying with us. Let me know your thoughts, comments, views, opinions in the comment section. Like this video. Hit the notification bell and select. I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.